Winner's concept usually just, well, concept. But this Hello Cooperman concept is real and it can be installed. Here is the desktop, but before that, let's round to the setup. The Windows PE is taken from Windows 8, which is why the loading sprite is a spinning dot. The setup interface is heavily redesigned in order to match the Hello Cooperman's concept design. Next to OBE. Now, this is the real graphic design is my passion. Based on WPF, you see the Windows logo at the top animates, even though it's quite laggy. The rest is Windows Vista setup with complete makeover to the design. Rebooting Windows, here's the concept video from Cooperman, and here's the concept in action. Although the Windows logo is not in color in the beginning due to the limitation, the waving animation and the rest is about the same. Login screen. Comparing it to the concept, it's about the same. Again, minus animation. Back to the desktop. Click on the start menu. The layout is similar to Cooperman's like the Windows logo at the bottom left corner. But the content of the start menu is a little different, such as on the left side is more packed than the concept. No setting and help button at the bottom and lack of icon animation. The Windows Explorer tried to copy the layout from Cooperman's concept, such as that detail pane, navigation interfaces at the top and down to the icon at the upper right corner, even though it is dummy buttons. It is for decoration, you cannot actually click on that. Libraries in here is displayed differently at the detail pane, just like what the Hello Cooperman's concept. Blue for my computer, red for music, violet for pictures and video, green for games, and orange for documents and the rest. Taking a look at the sidebar, this is a complete functional sidebar. You can run applications, searching on the internet, making to-do lists, check out the weather, media playback, news, and many other things which you can add by right-clicking and hover over to add tiles and edit any tiles by double-clicking. This is free real estate for ya. Applications in here is displayed as what it is on this Longhorn, such as Paint, WordPad, Notepad, Calculator, etc. But you get Windows 7 style applications too, such as Math Input Panel for you nerds, and on-screen keyboard. Internet Explorer is recreated by OGS to look as close as possible to the Longhorn 1, based on Internet Explorer 11. But due to that, this IE is buggy and looks a little bit out of place, such as the address bar. Pressing enter is navigating the browser, little to no option here and there. Windows Media Center is here with different color scheme, which is violet according to what Longhorn's supposed to see. As this is based on Windows 7, although the command prompt shows that this is boot 4096, one of the websites, whatismyos.com, reported that this is Windows 7 as well as Windows Media Center. One of the neat features in here is that you can set a Longhorn animated aurora as the desktop background by right-clicking desktop, clicking properties, going to desktop aurora, and you have four variants, red, gold, blue, and cyan. In this case, I will use the gold one. And look at that, it's very sick, pal. It also came with four themes, architecture, landscape, nature, and aurora. The first three is mostly taken from an actual default desktop background of a Longhorn build, which is awesome, whilst aurora is the still version of the Longhorn aurora that came in more colors. Control panel in here is redesigned to somewhat take the faith of current Windows Vista's welcome center. The WinVer here is customized to be a hybrid between Windows Vista's layout with Windows XP's fixed-sized windows. Look at that Windows logo animation. Ah! Because this is Windows 7, you can install Windows 7 programs, such as Sweet Home 3D, which is a building house simulator, or quote-unquote, house architecture virtual projection, as the fancy word. It installs and runs great. Despite the great creation by OGS for this mod, there are things that aren't right, such as the control buttons being out of place to click. As I click maximize, it closes. In analogy, this is still ghosted by Windows 7 control button layout. The Windows 7 control panel is, well, nothing. OGS confirmed that this is intentional to push users to use the Longhorn design one, and many other bugs which I can't mention it right now. In conclusion, if you want to try Hello Cooperman's Longhorn concept in action, you can install this mod, but disclaimer, as did in the 7, it loses main, extended and extended service update. You have to use this mod by caution. Anyways, you can download the ISO, the link will be in the description. Thank you OJS for making this mod, thank you for my Patreon supporter for making this video possible, and I'll see you in the next video of Everything Windows. See you next time, goodbye.